also time for the religious leadership to think again about the way that they want the prayers to act and to carry out their prayers. If we keep put aside the whole political situation, but using weapons in such a holy place like al-Haram al-Sharif and killing police, I don't think that serves anyone and any of the sides, and that's only make the whole situation more complicated. But nevertheless, I have to say that that's a time also for the religious leadership, as I said, in the Muslim community, where they have to think twice about the messages that they deliver for their prayers. And when we see that an hour after this, or a couple of hours after this terror attack, we say pray in Umm al-Fahim, in one of the main mosques there, where praised these terrorists. I think that's a very, very, very big questions here about what is the main role of the religious leadership. I'm not saying it just only on the Muslim side. Of course, I am aware also for the religious leadership in the other community. But I think that this is the time where I think that the reasonable and the people who understand the importance of living in peace and in mutual life in this part of the world, that we can't allow some religious leaders to lead these prayers to the extremism and for racism.
Dr. Amir Khnefis, Ashraf Al-Ajrami, thank you very much, and thank you for a call that all religious leaders around the world should listen to and should heed. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.